Thanks for having me. I'm going to crawl into that crib.
Perfect. Yeah, please do. We have Fielding Edlow, who is a stand-up comedian and a voiceover actor known for her role as Roxy on BoJack Horseman, which I love so much. And then also a mama.
I'm a mom. I always say, like, I don't identify as a mom. Like, I want that to come fourth or fifth or sixth, then, like, but yes.
So how many kids do you
just
have?
Just one.
Just one.
Done.
And one and done.
Done.
How old?
She's seven. She just said this morning, she goes, Mommy, what if you were pregnant right now? And I was like, I think I could have another one. Uh-huh. Of course, my husband's like, But yes, she's plenty. Like, we're exhausted. Sorry, I don't want to scare you. But we're, like, we have help. Uh-huh. I don't have, a big job. And I have a husband, and I'm exhausted with one.
I've seen you do comedy many times, but I laugh out loud every time you talk about your husband, whose name is Larry.
Hi, Larry. You better be watching this and learning from women.
You're hilarious on stage, and you talk about Larry, and you talk about your, you know, you kind of complain about Larry, and you have all these things about him.
That's a nice way to put it. That's like the nicest way to put it.
But what is your relationship with your husband really like in reality?
That's a good question. We laugh a lot, and like I'm able to be, nothing's uncensored, which is good and bad. We have the exact same, like we hate the same things, which is important.
That's a bonding
right?
thing.
Like we'll go off for 3 hours on like the second season of Barry and how horrible it is. Sorry. But like, you know what I mean? Like, and that's important to me.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're a fighting couple.
Like that's how you get along is through.
I mean, we're trying after 5 couples, we're trying to be like, I can't anymore do this.
Yeah.
Like there's a point where you're like, what a waste of time. But again, like we get easily triggered by each other even mm-hmm. still. Like we're still like, oh, I have to just touch him and be like, you're a great actor, mm-hmm. or you're good looking, or like, I know how to maneuver him.
Do you think, like, has having a kid changed your relationship or made it stronger or made you grind up against each other, not in the good ways, but
not in that, like, dry, humpy, wonderful in the shower.
90s, like, R&B kind
right,
of grinding.
Right, exactly, but... like, lift you up in the shower. I don't know if that's happened in like... Yeah, that's a great question. Stronger generally.
Yeah.
I mean, we have the like little gradations of like he would say, I buy too much shit and I hate that he gives her like, he's like doing this conditioned weirdness with food. I'm like, I've had an eating disorder. I know how this turns out.
Mm-hmm.
Stop putting conditions on food. He was a pretty shitty dad the first 2 years.
Oh.
I didn't say shitty, but just, he was scared. He was really super, I was scared too. I mean, I went on an anti-anxiety when I was nursing. Like, I was out of my mind with anxiety, and they were like, it's fine, and then I went off it.
What were the anxieties that you had?
I guess just generalized, like, can I sustain and nourish, and, like, what kind of mother am I right now? What's happening? You have a lot of time. I wasn't really on a project. I wasn't doing stand-up yet, so it was a lot. Time in your head's not great.
Mm-hmm. Did you have a lot of community or help or people who were like, do you
have had a night nanny, and that was a game changer. Yeah. Like, Larry would even lie to actors on auditions. Like, they'd be like, it's rough, right? And Larry'd be like, yeah, it's rough. And I'm like, keep that up, because, like, people get upset.
Yeah.
But we were really fortunate to have this incredible, we had her a while.
Yeah.
But the day, we didn't. Yeah, but it's a real purgatory, interesting time, and it's amazing. But unfortunately, I feel like I was sort of riddled with anxiety a lot of it. Because after 6 months and she slept through the night, I was like, okay, I can do this.
Yeah. I've heard so many good things about having, whether it's a nurse or a doula or just help.
And a doula too.
Yeah.
Even though she's playing like Words with Friends with Larry in the hospital. Literally.
All I want in life is to be a fly on the wall in your home. This is all I want. Like, whenever I hear you talk about your family and about Larry, I'm like, I have got to meet Larry.
Hopefully we can sell this piece of shit series that we're trying to sell called Bitter Homes and Gardens.
At I saw something. So what is Bitter Homes and Gardens?
So I wrote Bitter Homes and Gardens based on our dysfunctional, weird marriage. And I'll say in the pitch, like, it's a very blown out, exaggerated version of me. And Larry's like, it's you. It's 100% you. And then I'm like, no, it is Larry, but it's...
Right. It's almost like indirect couples therapy to write about your relationship in the form of a web series.
It is.
Yeah.
It's like a deep connection, the creative. Mm-hmm. So we bonded over that, and I feel like that is a huge connection for us, is that we love acting together. I mean, he's incredibly annoying when he gives me a note, and I'm like, no, I'm the writer, and I know what I'm doing. But we'll see.
Awesome. And thank you so much
for coming. Thank you. I can't wait to meet him.
I know, me too. And we'll have to get everyone back together so we can have a party.
I know. We should bring our kids.
Yeah. And like, So if you ever see Fielding on a show, you definitely have to go check her out because she's so funny.
Thank you. Right back at you.
Thank you. Hilarious. Thanks for coming here.
My sweaty Yiddish body.
Me too. Yeah, I'm so sweaty. It's okay.